Why is this computer freezing? There's a lot of answers to this. In this video, we'll be talking about this and what is the solution for this problem. Welcome everybody to Gamingtech. First of all, these fans are not that bad as I thought. I removed the bracket here that was holding the fan. So idea was to place this fan at the bottom compartment, so it would function as an intake. This part of the motherboard gets extremely hot. That is the second reason. Look, I haven't told you the first reason. I want you to guess what it can be. A lot of you complained about same problem. Computer from the outside feels extremely warm to the touch. This is due to the power supply. You're gonna be thinking like, how come? Because the strongest fan here sucking up all of the warm air is the power supply. First, I have to remove these zip ties that they used. I hate it personally when they do this. It's very hard to manipulate. I'm looking for the fan header here. They have done a very strange routing here. It's not a problem to find that though. Fairly simple. Before, I checked also if the cable's 24 pin or CPU pin cable being too bent. Not an issue like that. Everything is fine here. Fairly simple procedure. The reason I'm using these fans here, before we spend any money, what can we do? They're about worth 10 euro. I was estimating like 2-3 euro fan, 10 euro fan. Goes up to 1500 RPM. They weren't that bad. Problem is, with the motherboard and the settings they done, they go constantly to 500 RPM, regardless of temperature going up whatsoever. It's a setting they done, so I connected to my own motherboard here. And we're gonna do a simple toilet paper test. I mean, it's not actually correct test to do, but I want you to see the airflow when it's running on full RPM. There's a difference for sure. So we're gonna install this fan on the bottom. Unfortunately, this didn't help with the crashing, freezing, whatever you want to name it. So I'm going back to the what I was initially thinking was the main problem is the power supply. Power supply is very nice. 10-year warranty, Seasonic GX 750 watt. The problem is it takes all of the heat of the system. So what do we do here? I took the power supply out of the case, placed it on the top of the case. Zero crashes, zero freezes. The only freezing happened after having the computer on more than a day, where motherboard got too much warm. I'm assuming here VRMs, because this motherboard doesn't have any heat sink, anything else. Plus, we don't have the best fan to dissipate the heat, so as you see here, thought it was gonna work. Fix the cables here, thinking, hey, it's gonna be that easy. Unfortunately not. The biggest problem is this computer case. We have the front part covered fully. We don't have proper fans doing exhaust. We don't have proper fans doing intake. And what do we have? Just a lot of warm air circulating in the system. I done a gaming on it, done a rendering on it, zero crashing. Some of you were unsure which power supply they used on this Medion Erazer X10 engineer system. I will show you exactly which power supply it is. Motherboard is around worth 35 euro, which is really sad. You're gonna pay 2000 euro for a system like this, and you're gonna have problems because of the case, because of the fans. Some cable that they just tucked in. If we're not using it, it's a modular power supply. Hello, why do you add it there? Not a problem, I can just remove it. But Here we see the Focus GX750 power supply. Extremely quiet, quite nice power supply. That's the hybrid mode to activate the fan if you wish to do so. And here, zero issues. Obviously, is this a solution? Well, if you want to get rid of the freezing, it works. Boot time is completely fine. No complaints there. Thermals were okay. Also, another thing is this CPU cooler they used. When you have that kind of CPU cooler facing against the tempered glass, where is the air coming from? 75 to 80 degrees. And here, pay attention to this picture. Take a look at the red ones. That's the way they place the red intake fan. Doesn't function. Exhaust doesn't function. So I added the blue one at the bottom. And power supply is the yellow one, obviously. And we have the VRM parts of the motherboard. They also contribute to the heat of the system here. As you can see, you can add small copper heat sinks. It's an additional cost, but before the system is gonna crash, it's not gonna be because of the motherboard. It's gonna be 100% of the power supply. So this is important that you guys realize that. This is optional. I personally don't recommend it. You already spent enough. For people who are gonna ask if the power supply is good enough, yes. No issues. No problem with the gaming whatsoever. This is the solution. I mean, you can cut the top of the case or use it like this. I'm sorry, guys. This was the solution that I could come up with. Obviously, I can mod the case, but not everybody wants to do that. And it's not a realistic scenario in this regard. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like the video and share the video. Appreciate the support. Take care of yourselves. I'll see you on the next one. Let's go!